rivalry between ice cream makers reaches meltdown. Murder, She Wrote in half an hour on BBC One after Doctors.
Ridiculous girl. Never stops talking.
Is it all right?
Needs a bit more spray.
Well, she did put plenty on, Mum.
But you can't be thrashing about. Now, something old. Granny's pearls, something new. Well, that's easy. Something borrowed. My Liberty handkerchief. And something blue. I'm not convinced about this garter business, Victoria, but apparently it's de rigueur. Leave that, please, Brian. I hope you haven't given Kathleen any coffee.
No, I've set her off in the lounge, as per the schedule.
I can't hear much cleaning going on.
How you feeling?
Brian! Have a bit of sense!
I'm just a bit wobbly, Dad.
Big day. Yeah, I do look a bit off colour, though.
Stop fussing, Brian. She's absolutely fine. It's just nerves. Mind the hair.
She's not right.
You better stay here while I remind that woman what a vacuum cleaner looks like.
Water's running cold. I can't wash my hair.
It must be great for you. I haven't got to walk 5 miles for it.
Make us a coffee, would you?
Did you eat this?
Yeah, I was peckish in the night. It wasn't very nice, actually.
It's my last organic pink lady, but don't worry, I'll just take this half to work for lunch.
You're not serious you're going to eat that, are you?
No, Melody. I'm going to put it in the bin, here. And then I'm going to get another one from that magical place called the supermarket.
All right, there's no need to be like that. It's only an apple.
Last apple. My last apple.
You're being a bit weird about an apple.
Am I?
Yeah, and a teeny bit selfish.
Oh, yeah, of course, you're right, sorry. Kettle's boiled, so help yourself to my coffee and muesli.
How you doing, love?
I'll be out in a minute, Dad, I'm fine.
You're not convincing me, you've been like this for days.
Ryan! It's time to go through your speech.
Marvellous.
Schedule, Dad, you can't let me down.
I don't intend to.
Don't forget to plug the cushions.
Daphne.
I'm not happy about Victoria.
There's nothing the matter with Victoria. It's just nerves. Now, your speech.
I think we should call a doctor.
Brian, remember Great Form Music? She started the Mozart at such a lick, she ran out of fingers. Grade one ballet. The quarterfinals at the tennis club. Remember that?
I do, but...
The St. Ursula's Grammar Entrance Exam. She might have gone to university if she hadn't have felt hot that day.
She had chicken pox.
Oh, she could have sat that exam. You're always indulging her.
She's definitely not right. Why are you not listening to me?
Mill Health Centre.
Good morning.
My name is Brian Fortune. My daughter Victoria is getting married this afternoon. She's very unwell.
Can you speak up a bit?
I think she needs a doctor. She's been in and out of the loo for days now.
We can't send doctors out on a whim, Mr. Fortune.
I do think it's urgent.
All right. Address?
7 Langley Avenue.
I'll see what I can do.
Thank you.
Hysterical bride.
My home visits?
To add to the list of... sprained ankles, backache and bone idleness.
Bit harsh.
Well, the sad thing is, she's not far off the mark, looking at this lot. Mm.
So is there any particular reason you want to battle with the world today?
Is that what I'm doing?
Well, you made a good start.
I'm just not sure I want to be here.
Where would you rather be?
I'm supposed to be taking Sam out.
I don't think he's well enough for that.
He isn't, but he's insisting.
Well, that is asking a lot.
Are you suggesting I'm not up to it?
No, no, I'm just saying, you know, that it's a big commitment getting involved like that. Vivian, he's seriously ill. I'd be surprised if they let you take him out.
I'm already involved.
All I'm saying... Look, there's only so much you can do. I mean...
Yes. All right. Thank you, Dr. Clay. Now, if you don't mind.
Hi.
Morning.
Joe, would you say that I'm a thoughtful person?
Well, you're a doctor, so I'd be rather concerned if you weren't.
Yeah, of course I am. So you wouldn't say that I was selfish?
I'm sure you're not selfish, Melody.
Yeah, I didn't think I was.
But we can all definitely take more time to be more thoughtful. A little bit of thought and care with our patients is always appreciated and can often uncover the real problems.
And I have been thinking a great deal since breakfast, and I have decided to do something very thoughtful, selfless, in fact. Joe, you've taken cookery lessons, haven't you?
Yes.
Good. I might call you later about a couple of things.
Fine.
I think that's everything. This top layer can be lifted off so your makeup and toiletries can go at the bottom. There. What about that? You're distracting me with all your leaping into the bathroom. It's not the end of the world if something gets forgotten. I'll only be at Oakdale Hall for the night. Can always nip back.
What are you talking about? Of course you can't. What's the point of having a plan and a schedule if we just make it up as we go along? No, Victoria. It's all going to be perfect.
Nothing's going to spoil this wedding.
Flowers. You're very early.
Julia, I'm sorry to have to do this at such short notice, but I'm afraid I'm going to have to go for the day. I appreciate it's inconvenient and extremely unexpected, but I'm afraid it's unavoidable.
Vivian, what's wrong? Is there anything I can do?
I'd rather not elaborate, but I assure you I'm fine. It's just something that can't wait.
Well, yeah, okay, of course. I mean, it's not the best time, but if it's urgent, of course, yes.
I'll make up the time.
Who called you?
I wasn't going to sit around and watch her suffer a minute longer.
What were you thinking of? He knows Victoria suffers with her nerves. I'll show you out, Doctor.
He's not going anywhere until he's at least had a look at her.
Dad?
If the symptoms are cause for concern, especially today...
Come on, Daphne, we'll have a cup of tea downstairs.
Tea? You think I have time for tea?
So, Victoria, how have you been feeling for the past few days?
It isn't anything, really. I'm going to the loo more than usual.
And is it uncomfortable? Any traces of blood in the urine?
A bit.
Any pain in your abdomen?
Yes, been quite painful.
Right. Well, I'd like to examine you, so if you could lie on the bed for me. It's not the best time to be feeling like this. What time's the wedding?
4 o'clock.
And you've been like this a few days?
A week, maybe. But the past couple of days have been worse.
I suspect you've got a urinary tract infection. It may have advanced a bit since you haven't sought treatment.
Can you give me something now?
Well, I'm afraid it's not going to go after a few hours with standard treatment.
So it's quite serious?
Well... enough to be concerned. The infection could have advanced your kidneys, so it's best if we get it checked out of hospital. You may need IV antibiotics.
IV? That isn't something you can do.
No, I'm so sorry. I know this isn't what you want to hear, but I really think the hospital is the best course of action.
Cystitis?
Mrs. Fortune, your daughter has a urinary tract infection. It may be something serious, it may be nothing, but given the symptoms left untreated...
Nothing? You see, it could be nothing. It's her nerves. No one seems to listen. This is a nightmare.
Excuse me for a moment.
In the hole. I think Archie's going to love it. Well, he should. It was my dad's favourite. Not that I've ever made it before. Mum dealt with all that.
Melody, could you make this snappy?
Yeah. Sausages. What do you think?
Sausages, yes. Sausages. Packet of pork sausages would be fine.
Pork. Pork and herb. Pork and sage. Any...
Pork. Yes, pork or beef.
Pork. Right. And I'm a bit confused about eggs. The recipe says large, but...
I really need to go now.
So, Doctor, what do we do now?
She needs to get to A&E, so I'll put a call through and make sure she gets seen as soon as possible.
Well, she can't be long or the schedule goes to pot. You've got 2 hours. I better make some calls.
We appreciate that, thank you. I'll take it in, love.
Right, young man, I hope you're ready for this.
I need your tea sense.
I don't know about sense. I've abandoned work for this, so you better be suitably appreciative.
Of course I am.
I've cleared it with the nurses, and it's fine to go to the park as long as we're back by 5.
The park? What? We're going to play on the swings, are we?
We can't go gallivanting. Sam, it's just not possible. The staff would never allow it.
No, you're right. Don't put yourself out.
You don't look too bad.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to put you through this.
I've come to the conclusion that fathers are put on this earth so that daughters can make them suffer. But with the wonders of modern medicine, we should be back on track.
Can't wait to get me off your hands.
Last thing I want. Me alone with your mother, buying a tin hat. I'm delighted for you, love. You're going to make a beautiful bride.
Don't.
Not having doubts.
No, I love William.
There'll be a wait for the tests.
Ah, I'd best call your mum with an update. Must be at least 8 minutes since she had the last one. Anything I can get for either of you?
No, thanks. No.
I won't be long.
Well, you're looking much brighter. You'll be able to get out of here shortly.
Yes.
I couldn't help noticing that you were quite keen to get here. Are you worried about your wedding?
Just a bit nervous. I hate the idea of being on show.
It's perfectly natural.
It's always been the same. Mum blames my nerves, and she's right, I do get nervous.
You'd be abnormal if you didn't. I was a gibbering mess on my wedding day.
But I'm a gibbering mess all the time.
I do think there are different kinds of nerves. Those that are natural because it's important. And those that tell you that you're out of your depth, out of place. You've just got to decide. Ooh. Sorry, I better get that. Melody?
This recipe says that the oven needs to be on 220, but Archie's oven only goes up to the number 9.
Put it up high, it'll be fine.
Oh, you could be a bit more specific. Okay, hi.
You're a soft touch, Miss March.
Yes, that's what everybody says.
I wanted to go on the swings.
You can go back to the taxi if you're not careful, clever Dick.
Come on, push. Oh. I won't go up there without my turbo charge.
This is fine, Sam. We can stay here and admire the view.
No way. I'm getting up that hill. So come on, push.
Oh!
I've had a bit of a battle with the vicar. Not the best start to a wedding, but I've managed to put the service back an hour. I've organised around Robin. Uncle Clive has been driving me to distraction, so I've sent him off to deal with the caterers. That should keep him out of my hair for a while.
Mum.
Next thing I know, Kathleen rushes into the kitchen. I didn't know she could rush.
Mum, I don't want to get married.
It'll be fine, Victoria. Once your hair's sorted out and we get your makeup on, I promise you, no one will notice a thing.
Mum, I can't face it.
Not that service at St. Margaret's. Not any of it. I don't want this big wedding.
Victoria, love, how long have you been feeling like this?
Do you think it's the drugs?
This is it, Vivian. Look here.
Just give me a minute, will you?
Over there used to be my den. In those bushes.
A lovely view, I'll give you that. Are you hungry?
No. But you go ahead.
Or maybe later. You're looking a bit flushed.
I'm fine.
Nevertheless.
I'd forgotten how far you could see. Miles and miles.
You've got to calm down. Your heart rate's up a bit.
I'm all right.
I'm just saying.
Don't spoil it. We got here, didn't we?
Yes. Yes, we did.
Well, then.
She was fine this morning. What's brought all this up?
I don't think she's been keen on this whole extravaganza for a while.
Nonsense. How could she not want St. Margaret's?
She doesn't want a big fuss.
Brian, you can't have a wedding without a bit of fuss. I've already scaled it down to 100 guests. Honestly, you know how hard I've worked for this. You know how much organisation this has all taken. And Victoria gets a poorly tummy and suddenly she's not keen. Not keen? How bloody ungrateful is that?
Don't get upset, love.
Too late for that.
She doesn't want a big wedding.
Brian, I've just had an idea.
I see what you mean, sitting up here.
You can see so far. Like the next county. Miles. When I was having a bad time, I'd think about other people getting on with their lives and, you know, happy. And I thought, could be me.
There is a world elsewhere. Shakespeare.
You was right. Thank you for this.
My pleasure. You know, I spent all night once on a hill when I was young. My mother was furious. But it was worth it. Looking up at the stars and dreaming. Just like you. I was with a young man, actually. He was going away and we were saying goodbye. It got a bit cold, so he gave me his coat. And then we kissed. Never saw him again. Sam! Sam! Can you hear me? Sam! Oh no, not now. Oh,
okay, thank you. Dr. Fenton, you'll be happy to hear it's all sorted. I do hope you'll be able to join us.
Well, I'll do my best if you'll enlighten me.
The wedding. Poor Victoria. I realise she can't cope with the trappings of St. Margaret's. She's just not that sort of girl. This will be perfect. Exactly what Victoria wants.
And what does Victoria want? Exactly.
To get married here, in the little chapel. Can you imagine? It's just so delightful.
I've got the porter sponging the chairs now.
Is Victoria up to this, Mrs. Fortune?
That's the best part. It's a surprise. She will love it. They go to the right of the altar. Porter, see if you can move those chairs closer together. Start at the front. I think we'll have to send out for more. Darling. What do you think?
What possessed you?
Why are you doing this? You told me you didn't want some marble, so I went for something more modest.
Not now.
I was really quite ruthless with the list. I dedicated an hour and a half ringing round to send apologies. St. Margaret's this is not. But in many ways, it's better. The lighting for the photographs might be difficult, but otherwise, I think it's perfect.
Mum, will you listen? I didn't want St. Margaret's and I certainly didn't want this.
Then what do you want?
Please stop this.
Do you know how selfish you're being?
Mrs. Fortune, listen to your daughter, please.
I love William with all my heart. I can't wait to spend my life with him. But I don't want to be wheeled out and paraded. I just want to do it all quietly.
Then why didn't you?
You heard the doctor, Daphne.
I tried to tell you months ago, but you just get overexcited and take over. Suddenly it turns into one of your extravaganzas. I don't want to upset you, Mum, but maybe we won't get married at all. Perhaps we'll move into our flat and get married next year, or the year after.
You'll be nearly 35.
It doesn't matter, Mum.
It does to me.
I'll leave you.
Thanks, Doctor.
I suppose I've got everything out of proportion again, haven't I?
A bit, yeah.
Well, I'm sorry.
Me too.
What the heck?
Surprise!
What have you done?
I wanted to spoil you to say sorry. Look. Your delectation. Ta-da!
What is it?
It's a totally holy thing.
It's really burnt.
I think I'm gonna throw up.
You're cracking.
I know. I only wanted to do something nice for you. I'm sorry about the mess, Archie. I know that you don't like mess. But after this morning, you were so angry about your apple. So I just wanted to think of something to make it up to you. I bought specialty sausages and everything.
Oh, don't worry, it don't matter.
It does matter. You're so lovely and I've been such a pain.
Not really.
I have. I know I have. But I'm also a very sensual woman, Archie, and you're a very attractive man. So if we can't have Toad in the hole, maybe we can have something else.
Huh?
I know you want me, Archie Hallam, and I've always wanted you. Come here.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Look, I don't think we should do this right now.
Don't you like me?
Of course I do.
Well then.
Well, look, Melody, I just think you are really drunk and I don't think you're quite sure you know what you're doing.
Yeah, I do. I'm throwing myself at you. Are you turning me down?
I just think maybe you need a bit of sleep.
I don't want sleep. I want sex with you. But as I'm clearly not good enough, I'll just... I made you toad hole and you just throw it in my face. Well, fine, if that's the way you feel, then I will just go and I will leave you to cleaning up, because clearly that's the only thing that seems to get you excited.
Melody.
Don't Melody me. Right, I'm going to get out of your hair for good, Archie Hallam. Call me a cab. I'm going to pack.
Look, where are you going to go?
What do you care?
You know I do. Come on, let's get into bed.
Well, you've changed your tune, but sorry, the moment's gone.
Yeah, I didn't mean like that.
Come on, driver. Let's get out of here.
Melody, this is crazy.
Yeah, I agree. But that's life. You think that everything's a big bowl of roses and then it all comes back and bites you on the bum. You're so pretty. Drive!
Accident. I was in car. Fine now.
Well, it's good to know there's somebody around here who cares anyway.
He says she's from Moscow. She says she's from St. Petersburg.
I've already matched your client with one in particular.
And maybe you go to bank?
I feel as if I already know you.
So why don't you just shut up, grow up, and learn to deal with real problems for a change?
French and Saunders take on The Apprentice tonight at 9 on BBC One. Next this afternoon, it's Murder, She Wrote. The one to watch tonight.